Hallelujah. Just stretch your hands to heaven and just begin to magnify them. We thank you, Lord God, for you have freed us from fear. You have freed us from doubt, oh God. I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. Say, I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. Say, I'm no longer. Declare it of yourself. For I am. Child of God, I'm no longer
a slave to fear,
for I am a child of God. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me. Your love has called my name. I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me. Your love has. Hallelujah. I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. Say, I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. Say, I'm no longer.
Thank you. So Jesus said to those who had come to believe in him, "If you remain in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." But they answered, "We are the descendants of Abraham. We have never been slaves to anyone. So how can you say we will become free?" You see, they answered Jesus in the same way we might. I mean, we're Americans, right? We live in the land of the free. We sing songs about it. We get together and have parties and fireworks, all to celebrate our nation's freedom. But Jesus was speaking of a different kind of freedom, a freedom that can only be found in him. He answered them, "This is the truth. Everyone who chooses a life of sin isn't free. They are a slave to sin. A slave has no permanent place in the family. But a son or a daughter, they belong forever. So if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed."
All right, welcome, 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 the Bridge Community Online family. I would just like to welcome you to another special online presentation here at the Bridge Community, here in beautiful Southern California. But regardless of where you're logging in from, we would like to welcome you to today's online presentation. I hope that everyone had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful July 4th Independence Day. And actually, that's going to be the theme of today's message, and it is simply entitled Independence Day. So I'm going to open up in prayer, and we're going to get directly into the word today. Father, we thank you and we honor you. We bless you. We thank you, Lord God, for giving us this day. This is the day that you have made, and we are rejoicing and we are being made glad in it. Father, I thank you for each and every partner. I thank you for each and every listener and viewer who's listening now and who will listen to the video broadcast at a later date and time. Father, I just pray, Lord God, that you would open the eyes of their understanding, that you would open their ears, Lord God, so that they can hear what you wish to speak and deliver in this brief segment of time. Father, I decrease and I ask that you would increase in me. Stir up the gift of the teacher, Lord God, so that your people can grow, so that they can be edified, so that you may be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. Well, praise God. Let's go ahead and get into the word. And let me just do a quick disclaimer today. Today is just going to really be some things on my heart, some things on my mind. It's not really a very cute sermon or a three-point traditional sermon. It's more of my study, my meditation. So I'll just be sharing that with you. I know where God wants to take us, but I pray that today is a thought-provoking message and a message that's going to stir you to grow and change as a believer here in the United States. So again, our theme today is Independence Day. Independence Day. And my sub-question is, or my sub-statement is, independent but not yet free. Independent but not yet free. So let me give you just a quick overview so you don't get lost in today's presentation. We're going to start off with talking about the United States of America. We're going to kind of use that as a context. And then we're going to jump into some scripture so that we can get some biblical revelation. And then we're going to land or end in a personal context of how this is applicable to my life and to your life. Independence Day, Independence Day. And really, just let me just be honest and start off at the beginning here. Literally last night, I was wrestling with those two words all night. Independence and freedom. Independence and freedom. And I know a lot of times we use those words interchangeably, but the truth of the matter is they're not synonymous, and we're gonna see that. We're gonna see that because a lot of people, even this weekend, they were wrestling with, you know, do I celebrate the 4th of July, and how do I, you know, celebrate you know, this celebration, this holiday, in light of everything that's going on in the world. And we did celebrate. You know, we celebrated in the morning. We attended a wonderful event at a church right here in Englewood. It was a beautiful rally, a march, and just a wonderful event. And we went and hung out with family yesterday. So we celebrated, and us celebrating doesn't mean that we're blind to the complexity of the United States of America. So let's talk about the complexity of the United States of America, because I feel like in moments like this, the believer needs to know how to respond, how to pray, and how to discern everything that's going on. You know what I mean? We have to turn our thinkers on, we have to turn our spirits on, we have to turn our prayer lives on. And really, that's why we're in the midst of a series on prayer on Tuesday nights, because this is a time, this is a season where believers have to pray, and pray passionately and fervently, because again, our nation is in such topsy-turvy. So let's start off here with Independence Day. Independence Day, July 4th, 1776, is the day in which the pronouncement adopted by the Congress that the United States became a nation. This was like the first step in which the United States of America became an independent nation from the rule of Great Britain. Okay, so again, that was the birth, the formal birth of the United States of America. And in that birthing, the United States of America became independent. You got it? And we sing songs like Land of the Free and Home of the Brave. And, you know, that. But again, we got our independence. The nation got its independence. Not necessarily every citizen within the nation, but the nation itself got its independence. Because, you know, let's talk about some of the other, why it makes it complex, okay? Let's start with the Native American Holocaust, okay? By the close of the Indian Wars in the late 18th century, fewer than 238,000 indigenous people remained in the United States, a sharp decline from the estimated 5 million to 15 million living in North America when Columbus arrived in 1492. Those numbers are staggering. It says the numbers of indigenous people went from 5 million to 15 million down to 238,000 people, okay? And again, that was by the late 18th century. So again, we have the United States of America becoming independent, but then we have this backdrop of this Native American Holocaust, okay? What about Juneteenth? We understand Juneteenth as being the time in which June 19, 1865, that's when, in theory, the last slaves were notified that they were free, okay? Meaning they would no longer had to be slaves. There was other things that were put in place to try and, you know, kind of hinder our growth and us achieving, you know, this dream of in this independent country. But again, so we had Juneteenth. So again, that's June 19, 1865. But keep in mind, the country itself became independent in 1776, okay? Check this out. This is something that I hadn't even heard about in school at all. The Chinese Exclusion Act was authored May 6 of 1882, and that act prohibited all immigration of Chinese laborers. Up until that point, there were Chinese people that were in the nation working, but May 6, 1882, cut off, okay? That was an exclusion act saying there would be no more Chinese immigrants allowed in the United States of America. Last historical nugget here, many of us are familiar with the Japanese concentration camps. These were internment camps in which Japanese Americans, meaning they were currently in the United States, living with their families during World War II, they were forced to relocate and be incarcerated in concentration camps. And the numbers I found was about 120,000 folks that had to be forced into these concentration camps. And that was starting in 1942 through 1946. So again, we have the nation gaining its independence in 1776, but independence does not equal freedom. It doesn't equal freedom. And if you're typing comments, put that in the comments. Independence does not equal freedom. And that's why this has been a complex discussion for some, because the independence of the United States did not equate to freedom for all. Freedom for all. Okay? Let's read a couple definitions here and then we can get into some scripture. Independence. Independence is defined as a condition of a person, nation, country, or state in which its residents and population exercise self-government, and usually sovereignty over the territory. So again, that was the time. So again, in this context of our nation, independence was about us being able to be self-governed. Check this definition of freedom. Freedom means having the ability to act or change without constraint. Underline the word constraint. Something is free if it can change easily and is not constrained in its present state. That is, again, and these are some Webster's dictionary, that's independence and freedom. Here goes a biblical definition of freedom. And this is based off of John, the 8th chapter. It says freedom, and this is again a biblical definition. It says to make free, to set at liberty from the dominion of sin. To make free, set at liberty from the dominion of sin or from another's control. Independence Day. Independence Day. So really my thesis in this is that the United States of America is an independent nation, but it is not necessarily free to each and every one of its citizens. That is the tension that we're going to talk about. And why I'm talking about this in a church setting is us as believers, we need to understand the difference between independence and freedom. Because at the end of the day, the church's posture in this hour should be the hope that our nation will not only be independent, but our nation will be free. Now, this is a time when y'all could call CNN. Y'all could call MSNBC, you could call Fox News, because this is what God has put on my heart. We're wrestling not between independence, but we're wrestling with freedom. And us as believers, we need to understand what freedom is. Let's turn in our Bibles to Luke, the fourth chapter. Again, anybody know Jesus? Huh? Let's see what Jesus said. He says, Luke 4:18, it says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. Watch this, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. So again, Jesus comes on the scene and makes a big announcement that it is he that the prophet Isaiah prophesied about, And he said, guess what's in my bag, y'all? What's in my bag includes, watch this, deliverance to the captives, recovering of sight to the blind, and setting at liberty them that are bruised. Check this out now. This is what messed me up about this. Jesus could have easily came and preached the independence of Israel from Roman occupation. He could have done that. He could have said, guess what, y'all? We about to be independent. But no, Jesus came and said, freedom is the goal. And that's, as a believer, you have to understand the difference between the two. You got it? And this is, I know in the last few weeks, we've been talking about waking up to the cries of the people. This is a time when we need to wake up to the cries of the people. The nation has its independence, but there are people that are not yet free. If children are locked in cages in the United States of America, their cries should be, they should be ringing in your ears. If you're a believer, if you're a person of intercession, if you're a person of prayer, you should hear those babies' cries. You got it? We're wrestling with independence and freedom. Independence was a goal. You got it? That's a bar, that's a standard, but true independence is freedom and liberty for all. Jesus said, he said, I came, watch this, to preach deliverance to captives. That's what he said. Turn over me with you in your Bibles to Acts 16. And this example is going to be so, I can't say what it's going to do for you. It blessed me because, again, I found this passage of scripture being so prophetic because it's applicable to what we're wrestling with today. Independence versus freedom. Acts the 16th chapter. And I'm just going to set it up, right? Because, again, I'm not trying to impress anybody. I'm going to just set this up. As we read this scripture about this slave girl, this is what I want you to think about. And you could type in the comments these three things: a system, a biblical response, and freedom. That's how we, those are going to be the three things as we read this passage. That's what we're looking at. We're going to be looking at a system, a biblical response, and freedom. Okay? So let's get into this. Acts, the 16th chapter, and we're going to pick up in the 16th verse. And it came to pass, as we went to prayer, a certain damsel possessed with the spirit of divination met us, which brought her masters much gain by soothsaying. Now this is very interesting now. Let's park very quickly. Very quickly, we have a damsel, in other words, watch this, a slave girl that was possessed, right, with the spirit of damnation. And guess what? She was getting her owner's money. Somebody say system. Put system in the chat, because obviously this was legal in the day, where you could have a child that's under the influence of a demonic principality. And guess what? People, they were making money off of her. That is a system. You got it? Verse 17, the same followed Paul and us and cried, saying, these men are the servants of the Most High God, which show unto us the way of salvation. And that's a clue, because guess what? Demonic people, demonic influencer, or people under the influence of demonic spirits, they know the presence of God when the presence of God shows up. But that's a whole nother sermon. Verse 18, And this did she many days, but Paul, being grieved, turned and said to the Spirit, watch this, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out of the same hour. So here we see a biblical response to this system. You got it? We see a system, a slave girl that was being tormented by a devil and people were profiting off of her condition. Now we see a man of God come along and the man of God responds biblically. And what happens after he responds biblically? Freedom manifests. Not independence, but freedom. Because it says that that spirit came out of her. Verse 19, and when the masters saw that the hope of their gains was gone, they caught Paul and Silas and drew them into the marketplace unto the rulers. Okay, so now these people that were basically pimping in the system tried to bring Paul and Silas, who disrupted to the system, to the same system so that judgment can be entered. I hope you guys are seeing the parallels, because we're seeing systems being manipulated by men and people for their own selfish gain, and you see holy and righteous men of God respond, and what do they do as they're responding? They're disrupting a system that was wicked. You got it? So they brought them into the marketplace of the rulers and brought them to the magistrates. These men, being Jews, do exceedingly trouble our city and teach customs which are not lawful to us to receive, neither to observe, being Romans. And the multitude rose up together with them, and the magistrate ripped off their clothes and commanded to beat them. So again, we see the response of these men of God being met with beatings by the system. You got it? Because again, the power of God, and that's why we read Luke 4. Jesus said, what did he say? I came to set those at liberty that are bound. Here we see Paul and Silas. I'm gonna do what my big brother said, and we're gonna loose this little girl, and that's what they did. The system wasn't ready for freedom. So that's why I'm saying, believers, be careful how you use these terms. The goal was not 1776 independence. The goal is freedom for all. That's the goal. That's the goal. So don't get caught up in all these mind trips and political trickery that's going on. Let's operate in scripture. You got it? Let's operate in scripture here. They teach customs, and when they had laid many stripes. So the men of God got beat because, watch this, they disrupted a system. So again, think it not strange, and some of y'all are having fits because the governor said don't sing in church today. If you're in church, go ahead and sing. But again, think it not strange, because we see what scripture is telling us. These men of God ministered to a slave girl, and what happened? They got thrown in prison. They got beat, and then they got thrown in jail. And the multitude rose together against them, and the magistrates ripped their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the dead jailer to keep them safely. Who, having received such a card, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. So again, just briefly recapping now, and I don't want to get too excited because I may lose some of y'all. We see a system. We see a biblical response to a system, and then we see freedom, and now we see that system trying to prevent freedom. See, that's the thing, y'all, and that's what I'm saying. You got to stay with me, because we're doing an overlay. We're overlaying scripture on top of what's going on right now and what's been going on, you know, throughout the history of this country, because I'm trying to wake you up. You can't let other people think for you. You can't let other people pray for you. You can't let other people discern from you. You have to begin to wake up to what's in this word and in this scripture. You got it? Then it says, verse 25, and at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's bands were loosed. So here we see a second biblical response. And I don't know if that's a good title for it, being a biblical response, but, you know, again, we're talking about scripture, because we see Paul and Silas operating in the word of God. Okay. They operated in scripture by ministering deliverance to the slave girl. And now we see them operate in scripture by praying and worshiping in prison. And what we see is that the system was unable to withhold this biblical response. Do you see that? The system was unable to hold the biblical response, because we saw an earthquake come and the foundation of the prison was shaken, and immediately all the doors were open. That's why it's so important that we respond biblically with accuracy. Because if you respond biblically but in error, guess what? The system that is unjust will not change. You got it? And again, I hope that this is making sense to y'all. Because we're seeing the difference between independence and freedom. And we're seeing our job as believers to respond biblically in power and in accuracy, and systems begin to change and shift. You got it? Glory to God. Let's find somewhere to land the plane here. Personal context, okay? What tripped me out about doing this overlay is how the United States mirrored my life. And I'm gonna make that make sense right now. Independence Day was almost like when I got saved, you know. In other words, I accepted Jesus Christ as my Savior, but not necessarily as my Lord. So there were things inside of me that were not freed. Our true liberty had manifested. You got it? So that's why, again, as I'm doing this overlay, God showed me the United States with its independence is just like your life as a follower of Christ. I'm still trying to get there. You got it? And this nation is trying to get there. We praise God for all of the progress that has been made, you know, over the last few hundred years. But guess what? Freedom is still not a reality for each and every person that is in the United States of America. And that's what I'm trying to help you see yourself in this. Because guess what? This is Independence Day. I believe that this is your day of freedom, so that at an individual level, you can tap into the freedom that Christ made available unto you. A couple questions to ponder as we close. And this is my thesis statement. The USA is independent, but it's still not free. The United States of America is independent, but still not wholly free. My question for you is, because I gotta drive it to right where you're at. What still continues to have you in bondage? And I'm not talking about the system. Now, we're gonna put the system stuff on the side. I'm gonna talk about in your own life, in your spirit, soul, and body. What still continues to have you in bondage? That's my first question. My second question is, what system, I guess now we'll bring the system back, what system still continues to restrict you? What system still continues to restrict you? And thirdly, what weapon have you employed for your freedom? What weapon have you employed for your freedom? And that's where we can borrow from Paul and Silas. They employed weaponry to minister freedom to, watch this, the slave girl and to the system. So you have to ask yourself, what weapon have you employed for your freedom? In closing, turn with me over in your Bibles to John the 8th chapter. John the 8th chapter. If you're getting something out of this, type in the comments. I'm getting something out of this. I'm getting something out of this. John the 8th chapter in the 32nd verse. And hit the share button. Hit the share button here. John, I'm in the wrong place. John the 8th chapter. And we're going to read, start at verse 32. And again, this is just going to drive this whole freedom thing home. It says, verse 31, then Jesus said to those Jews which believed on him, if you continue in my word, then are you my disciples indeed. In verse 32, it says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. The truth shall make you free. Verse 33, they answered him, we be Abraham's seed and were never in bondage to any man. How save thou, ye shall be made free? In other words, what's all this freedom thing about? Verse 34 says, Jesus answered them saying, verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committeth sin is the servant of sin. Verse 35, and the servant abideth not in the house forever, but the Son abideth ever. If the Son shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Somebody type in the comments, free indeed. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Therefore, if the Son makes you free, you shall be free indeed. This is not your day of independence. This is your day of freedom. And this is my prayer and hope for each and every one of you, that your eyes would be opened to see God's hand moving even in this hour, that your ears would be open to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is speaking unto the church, that your hearts would be open for the direction and the wisdom and the knowledge and the plans that God wants to download into your heart. This is your day of freedom. And I declare that your days of being like the slave girl, being manipulated by demonic principalities, is absolutely over. I declare that you are free because Christ has made you free. I declare that you are free because you are knowing the truth and you're receiving the truth. That's the thing. Let the truth get all up inside of you and drive out any falsehoods, any ideologies, any mindsets that are contrary to the true gospel of Jesus Christ. That's my prayer from you today, is that this is your day of freedom. Type in the comments, freedom. Freedom now in the name of Jesus. That's what was so powerful. Again, I'm going back to Paul and Silas. They ministered freedom right where they're at. It wasn't a prerequisite for independence. That wasn't even a prerequisite, because again, that freedom manifested. It manifested right in the middle of an unjust system and a corrupt system with corrupted leaders. It manifested. Because what? Because God was with them. I decree and I declare that God is with you and his hand is resting upon you today and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. And praise God, praise God. Hit the share button, hit the share button, y'all. We want to share this word with as many people as possible. We thank you for tuning in today. And at this time, I would like to invite you to make a donation. Our production team is going to put some information on the screen for you today. There's multiple ways in which you can give. You can give by way of Givelify, our website, or the Cash App. We praise God that the Bible says, given it shall be given back to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall people give back unto you. So we know that God honors your generosity. And we pray that God would do just that, that he would return back unto you. We would like to thank all of our financial partners. We are building this church. We're building it out, y'all. God is speaking, and we got some really exciting things to share with you in the days and months to come. And we would like to invite you to join us on Tuesday for our Zoom Bible study. Join our Facebook group. If you're not in our Facebook group, there's a link inside the comments for you to do so. That is the living room. That's where we hang out. Matter of fact, we'll be hanging out tomorrow evening for our recap. Me and Jamila just kind of hanging out, getting connected with y'all. And we just love y'all. So we pray that you have a wonderful day, that God will continue to keep his hand on you, and that no sickness, harm, or danger will come near you. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful, wonderful afternoon.